Hey guys, welcome to the world of track biking. Let's get this started. A very good evening, people. Now the time is 6 o'clock in the evening. Today is Saturday. I'm going from my office to home, and I'm very much excited because after a long time, I'm doing the motor vlogging here. Bro, I'm trying to do some video. Please try to stop your horn, man. Honky, honky. Okay, so let's concentrate. So let's get into the topic. So the negative point one. I know this may be a silly point, but it's an important point. Please concentrate. Can you see this date? Can you see this time? It's showing 6:10 p.m. but actually now the time is 6 o'clock, or even below that, 5:55, I believe. From the day one, I'm trying to adjust the time for a proper proper IST. So what is happening is, after a couple of days, what happens is it's jumping its time, man. Its seconds are jumping like anything. Now it is almost 10 minutes now. I don't know why. KTM, what happened to this? That is one of the main negative point which I noticed from day one to here. And next thing would be, if you are buying a bike, you feel that you should have a proper fitment, and all the stuff should be in their respective places. Why I'm telling this is, a couple of days before, my rear tire mudguard, it came out immediately. I don't know why. When I checked up, there were 3 bolts which is fitted to that mudguard. After that, when the mudguard came out, at that point of time, there was only one bolt which was hanging around. So to cross check, I just tried to inspect other areas like the grab rail. When I tried to tighten the grab rail, man, I was surprised, man, because even that grab rail was not tightened properly. I was able to feel few rounds. I did few rounds of tightening, man. That is strange. Why KTM? Why? I love this KTM bike, but these small mistakes may affect in future. Please, I request KTM to look after this. I don't know why it is happening. Maybe only my bike is having this problem, but this is disappointing. Yeah, it is totally disappointing. This is the worst ever traffic toll in the world, because look at this mess. Everywhere people will come. Even if you are thinking to follow the rules, you will never do this. See, man, this is the electronic city toll for you guys. Horrible, man, horrible. Oh my god, are they serious? So what shall I do? This is not the right place to go, because since it is a Saturday, I can go to the left side of that. So left side of the toll will not have that much traffic jam in the bike section, because it is Saturday. All IT guys will not be working. Good for me, at least. So, and one more point is there. I know I have discussed, or I have told you guys so many times, several times, but even I want to tell now. Let me clarify that. Yesterday, there was a situation where I had to travel from my office to home. So there what happened was, I did not take this toll. There is a road below that, so that is also one of the national highway. The thing is, let me come out of this and I'll let explain, start explain, whatever. I am free now. So where I was, yes, yesterday I did not took this toll. It was an unfortunate situation that I had to go down. It took me like nearly 1 hour, I believe, to cross the 11 kilometers. So that point of time, what was happened was, the engine which KTM has, that to 390, heats up a lot. Heats up a lot. If you know, it heats up like anything, and you feel that your leg is cooking on the stove. I'm clarifying you guys, if you are totally into the city riding, please man, please don't try to use this. Even if you buy, please don't try to use this daily. I don't know why I felt like that. I was irritated like anything because of that heat condition and the traffic jam. Each signal I waited for nearly 3 to 4 times, like nearly 10 to 15 minutes. That was a horrible time. So at that point of time, if you use this kind of bike, you will be totally frustrated. So just please don't try to use that in the traffic conditions. That is a major negative point for you. And one more negative point is linking with the previous point, because it matters. So if you are riding in a traffic jam, and if you want to filter your bike, if you are using the KTM Duke 390, then it is not possible in all the situations, because the handlebar is wider. It's more wider than any other bikes. Because of that, you cannot even go in the gullies. So even though the engine is supporting you, but the handlebar will not support you. That is the most disappointing thing. Out of 100%, you can use only for max to max of 40 to 50% in the Bangalore condition. I don't know about other cities. In Bangalore condition, you cannot use like that because of this wider handlebar. So these are the things which I felt, which I felt personally. So I don't know, this is my thought. Please don't try to quote me on these things. These are the points, guys, which you have to consider before you buying it. So that's why I'm telling you, please try to be more practical, so before buying it. Having said that, I think, hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. I have tried it in a casual way. If you like this video, hit a like button. And if you are not following me on Instagram and Facebook, this is the handle which you have to go there and click a follow, man. Do it. I'll be sharing my stories. And come and join to the hood rack biking community. As always, ta-da, bye-bye, see you, and see you in the next videos.